Inspiring cobra, expiring cobra.
Most of us who come to yoga do so to address some kind of pain, whether physical or emotional. Our intention is to teach yoga as a way of living, so that for people who come and practice, it is not just a physical exercise.
So from the pelvis down, your legs are rooting like the roots of the tree. It is at this point of balance that we find between the trust and the freedom. The transformation happens. It's always about the balance.
It's more of a holistic approach, so that they actually see their quality of life change.
Find that center again. Find that back body through which we all receive support in everything in life, not just in yoga practice. So when we feel that wavering, we remember that there's something steady despite the wavering, that even allows the wavering to happen. Εδώ μένω στο πίσω όμως, πίσω όμοιρος, εισπνοή, πάμε, καρδιά ψηλά, πίσω πίσω η όμοι, πίσω το κεφάλι.
I found the glimpse of myself that I sensed I had lost.
Like a breeze, it's a breath of fresh air, it's affirmation, it's challenge to my preconceived ideas, it's a challenge to those things that I'm trying to work on.
La prise de conscience de la respiration te permet de te calmer, de calmer tout ton corps, de te reposer et te permet de commencer un voyage intérieur que j'avais jamais fait.
You just get to the more to the essence of how you are somehow, and all the rubbish, the everyday stuff, and it just sort of gradually dissolves somehow.
The magical thing about yoga is that it spills over into all areas of our lives. So the indication of whether the practice is going well is how your life is evolving, really. So it's not about how well your asana is or how perfect this pose or that pose.
I've found many ideas that were touched on in the philosophies that we spoke about in the retreat, in the intentions, in certain yoga practices that I was able to keep and help in so many ways when I was not in the retreat anymore, when I got back to my normal life.
From the practice, it gives me a sense of ritual in my life, and gives me a sense of reverence for life. And so with having that, I'm able to sort of reverence other people's lives, meaning that I can accept them more. Just like I'm trying to accept myself more, I can accept them and their strengths and their weaknesses more and more and more.
Il y a cette notion de changement qui est là, il y a cette volonté de changement qui est là, alors qui se contrebalance avec un parcours de vie que j'ai déjà, et une façon de m'accepter en tant que moi-même, mais de toute façon, il y a cette volonté d'améliorer et de modifier certaines des attitudes.
In fact, other people noticed, they said you seem much calmer. Because I can sometimes get quite bad tempered quite quickly, and yoga calmed that down. And my posture, that I didn't even notice that change. Generally, I don't get stressed about things so much. I can take a step back.
Yoga is about acquiring a different stance towards all circumstances, so that you can turn obstacles into opportunities for growth, for personal growth, and for such growth that will affect all the people of your environment as well.
It's been great. It was this beautiful, unexpected thing. And everyone that asks me about it, I say that I found it by chance, and it was such a good chance. Many, many new things that I learned, this eye-opening chance, and I was smiling the whole time, and it was really a beautiful experience. And I went back to, I'm living in Switzerland, and I went back to Switzerland and my job and my friends, feeling more grateful, more happy, ready to start again my work for the year. They are very basic yoga principles, but they were some things that I could really use and found very helpful. And I stuck with them through the year. Whether it be physical or not, I felt that by doing these actions, I chose and I made some positive change for myself. So it was, so yes, and then I came back again, and then I came back again. Yeah.
Standings of the asanas, things like that. It's how I digest that information, which then helps me to interact with the world in a way that really eliminates violence. It eliminates the seeds, the seeds of violence. I want to try to change myself and feel that I can offer more positivity in the world and to myself first and foremost. Yeah. It was a wonderful, really wonderful experience.
Mia praktiki terapias me din asana me tis fasis yoga θα είναι και θεραπεία της προσέγγισης προς το σώμα.
Η γιόγκα ήρθε, θα έλεγα, τυχαία στη ζωή μου. Δεν την έψαχνα, εκείνη με βρήκε και ήταν πραγματικά μια πολύ αποκαλυπτική στιγμή.
Υποψίαστη έφτασα στη γιόγκα. Αυτό όμως που με κρατάει, με κράτησε και με κρατάει μάλλον, είναι ότι αρχίζεις και βλέπεις ότι υπάρχει και ένας άλλος τρόπος να λειτουργήσεις τη ζωή σου από αυτόν που είχες μέχρι τώρα. Πιάνεις τον εαυτό σου να λειτουργεί πιο συνειδητά σε καθημερινές καταστάσεις και λες κάτι υπάρχει εδώ, ας το ακολουθήσω. Και ξεκινάς ένα μονοπάτι που απλά σε πείθει να θες να το συνεχίσεις και να το προχωρήσεις και να το διευρύνεις ενδεχομένως.
Ανακαλύπτεις πτυχές του εαυτού σου που δεν ήξερες καν ότι υπάρχουν. Οποιοςδήποτε και αν είναι ο λόγος που ξεκινάς τη γιόγκα, είτε γιατί σου αρέσει σαν φιλοσοφία, είτε γιατί σαν γυμναστική, αναπόφευκτα μπαίνεις στο μονοπάτι και σε οδηγεί σε ένα άλλο κόσμο, θα έλεγα.
Τελικά όλα συνδέονται με τη γιόγκα και με αυτό που κάνεις και δεν είναι η ζωή κάτι ξεχωριστό, ας πούμε, και το στρωματάκι κάτι ξεχωριστό.
Η γιόγκα σε προκαλεί να να την κάνεις με τη μέγιστη προσοχή, τη μέγιστη αγάπη, τη μέγιστη επίγνωση. Σιγά σιγά αυτό αρχίζει να διαχέεται, ας πούμε, και στα υπόλοιπα κομμάτια της ζωής σου. Και ξέρεις ότι όπως είσαι στη γιόγκα, έτσι θες να είσαι και στους υπόλοιπους τομείς. Σαν να λειτουργεί σαν μια μεταφορά, ας πούμε, για τον εαυτό σου έτσι όπως το θέλεις.
Κρατάω ένα απίστευτο ταξίδι. Το είδα αυτό ταξίδι. Όλο αυτό. Ταξίδι προς τον εαυτό μας, αλλά αυτό είναι το πιο δύσκολο ταξίδι που έχουμε να κάνουμε. Με πολύ δυνατές εμπειρίες, πολύ δυνατά συναισθήματα.
Το ζητούμενό μου ήταν να βρω περισσότερη ηρεμία στην καθημερινότητά μου, αλλά τελικά βρήκα πολλά περισσότερα από ηρεμία. Και ήταν πραγματικά σαν να άνοιξε πάλι μια καινούργια πόρτα και να λέω, ναι, αυτό θέλω να κάνω στη ζωή μου. Η ενασχόληση με τη γιόγκα μου έδωσε και μια μεγαλύτερη σιγουριά στο να ακολουθώ αυτά που νιώθω. Εντάξει, γενικά λέμε να βρίσκουμε τον εαυτό μας, αλλά πραγματικά αναγνωρίζω πολύ πιο συχνά τον εαυτό μου και τον στηρίζω πιο εύκολα τώρα γνωρίζοντας τη γιόγκα από ότι πριν. Πριν μπορεί να μην ήμουν σίγουρη για κάποιες αποφάσεις.
Προσωπικά πιάνω τον εαυτό μου να αντιδρά νοητικά και συναισθηματικά πολύ διαφορετικά. Πολύ διαφορετικά και ομολογώ ότι δεν το περίμενα.
Really truly believe that we are entering a new era where there will be much less competition and much more cooperation. We see this, we witness this everywhere. And yoga is everywhere, really. Nowadays, yoga is also in hospitals, in schools, and it's so beautiful to be a part of this, we can call it a world movement, where people's perception of themselves in relation to others is changing. Practicing asanas, poses of awareness again and again, meditation, self-contemplation, bring about clarity of mind. And this in turn makes us experience our essence, our own source, the true nature as the scriptures talk about. With that deepened or heightened, if you will, awareness, we begin to act in the world spontaneously, more or less, with more kindness, empathy, and love. One of the things, for example, that becomes more important is how can we raise our children, the future generations, compassionately, with understanding, and what will the values be that they will absorb from us? Another urgent issue becomes how we treat the planet. What do we consume? What do we financially contribute to? We become more sensitive to people in need and more actively engaged in activities that help such groups of our society. If I had to put it in one sentence, I would say that overall, yoga helps us expand. It changes the way we perceive the world and the way we stand in the world. And this world that we are talking about is not something outside us anymore, because we begin to prioritize not that which separates us, but that which unites us as conscious beings, beings who are traveling together on this extraordinary journey of life.